Will you enter into a spirit of prayer with me? Gracious God, we thank you for the blessing of this evening and all of the promise that it holds. We thank you for planting the seeds of integrity, civility, and responsibility within the heart of each student. We thank you for California University, which tended and nurtured these characteristics along with wisdom, laughter, and deeper self-understanding. Make sacred these moments we share together celebrating each accomplishment. Hear our silent memories as our offerings of thanksgiving. May every moment spent in study blossom into bold action for the common good, and may each of us never lose sight of the brilliant potential left in our keeping. Amen.
You may be seated. Good evening, And welcome to California University of Pennsylvania's 182nd commencement celebration. I'm Dr. Bruce Barnhart, Acting Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, and it's my pleasure to introduce members of the Platform Party and several other persons here with us tonight. I will begin introductions with those seated in the back row and ask each person to stand as his or her name is called. And may I ask that you, the audience, hold your applause until everyone is introduced. Dr. Stephen Whitehead, Associate Provost for Innovation and Associate Vice President. Dr. Daniel Engstrom, Associate Provost for Academic Success and Associate Vice President. Mr. Douglas Hoover, Dean of Library Services. Dr. John Callis, Dean, Eberly College of Science and Technology. Dr. Muhammad Yamba, Dean, College of Liberal Arts. Dr. Kevin Corey, Dean, College of Education and Human Services. Dr. Stanley Kamasik, Dean, School of Graduate Studies and Research and Associate Provost. Dr. Nancy Pinardi, Vice President for Student Affairs. Mr. Robert Thorne, Vice President for Administration and Finance. Mr. Tony Morrow, Associate Vice President, Development and Alumni Relations. Mr. Brendan Gary, Student Government President. The Reverend Jana Quisenberry, Pastor, California United Christian Church. Dr. Christina Torres, Chair and Associate Professor, Department of Professional Studies, and tonight's Herald. Dr. Paul Hettler, Professor and Chair, Department of Business and Economics, and Faculty Marshal. Mr. Sean Logue, Member, Council of Trustees. Mr. Thomas J. Urim, Member, Council of Trustees. Ms. Annette Ganassi, Vice Chair, Council of Trustees. Mrs. Vanessa DeSalvo Getz, Class of 1993, tonight's guest speaker. Geraldine M. Jones, University President, California University of Pennsylvania. Representatives from the Alumni Association, who will be presenting alumni pins to the graduates, are seated to my left. Mrs. Leslie Fleener, Class of 2008, Director of Alumni Relations, and Mrs. Kathy Conley, Class of 1995 and 1996, Director of Major Gifts. Now, under the direction of Dr. Hugo Eikach, the University Choir will now present Come Sail Away by Styx. Thank you.
So the story goes, but somehow we missed out on the pot of gold.
But we'll try best that we can
to care.
Good evening, University Trustees, Mrs. Getz, Reverend Quisenberry, distinguished guests, parents and family members, and members of the graduating class of 2016. Welcome to California University of Pennsylvania's 182nd commencement ceremony. I would like to begin my remarks with a special thank you to our faculty for their hard work and dedication on behalf of our students. You have demonstrated your commitment to teaching, mentoring, and challenging our students, and we thank you for your contributions. Please, faculty members, stand and be recognized at this time. Graduates, congratulations on this milestone in your life, and welcome to California University's alumni ranks. Like so many others gathered here today, I am very proud to be associated with California University. This great institution has been an important part of my life, and now that you are entering the alumni phase of your association with CalU, I encourage you to remain close with your alma mater. Your fellow alumni and the professors and staff members who have made a difference in your lives. Please know that I'm also very proud of each of you for your hard work and the sacrifices you have made to reach this point. I know that you will continue to work hard as you enter this new chapter of your life as a university graduate. You have important work ahead of you. The work of building a meaningful life and contributing as a member of this global society we live in. I am very much aware of the role each of you will play in the future of our country and our world. It is up to you, as knowledgeable, purposeful, and caring human beings, to help change lives, reshape communities, and make the world a better place. Each of us has a responsibility to care for our fellow man. No matter what career path you choose, those special moments you spend taking time to understand, help, and mentor others will shape you into an even greater human being. I encourage you also to discover and acknowledge people's strengths and to utilize those strengths on behalf of the greater good. This is true in any setting. We all become stronger when individuals are encouraged to contribute their best efforts to a common purpose. Although you'll receive your degree today, please recognize that your education is not done. Every day brings new opportunities for learning, and I have always believed in the power of lifelong learning to enrich our lives. Volunteering for committees, for special projects, and for new assignments will help you develop skills that will make you an even more effective leader. Always remember to celebrate success and share the credit when things turn out well. When you have many responsibilities, it's tempting to focus all of your time and attention on the trouble spots. But we all need to have balance in our lives. It's worthwhile to take a moment and enjoy the small victories that brighten your day. Trust in your own abilities and talents. And no matter what happens, you must follow your own moral compass. Be courageous and know that you can and will make a difference for those you meet along the way. As you prepare to walk across the stage this evening, please pause. Take in the moment and savor your success. You have worked hard, you have persevered, and you have accomplished something significant. Please think of your parents, spouses, family members, and friends who helped and encouraged you. Let those special individuals know how much their encouragement, love, and support means to you. All of us here at CalU, our trustees, administrators, faculty, and staff, and your fellow alumni are proud of you and your achievements. We offer our heartfelt congratulations to every one of you. We wish you all the best on your individual journey. May you find happiness and satisfaction in the days and years ahead. Congratulations. Thank you.
It is my distinct pleasure to introduce this evening's guest speaker, Mrs. Vanessa DeSalvo Goetz, class of 1993. Vanessa DeSalvo Goetz is the founder and president of Salvo Strategies, a public and government affairs firm based in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. With a career spanning over two decades, she's a fixture in the inner circles of the Pennsylvania political elite. Mrs. Goetz's career began in 1992 in the office of the House of Representatives. In 1993, she joined the iconic Pennsylvania government relations firm, Greenlee Partners, as Director of Special Projects and rejoined as Managing Director in 2007. Mrs. Goetz's core competencies include networking, fundraising, media, policy, research, and grassroots initiatives within all levels of government. She has been an often sought-after strategist, information analyst, and event planner for campaigns, from school boards to the Supreme Court over the past 23 years. A top-notch fundraiser, Mrs. Goetz has raised tens of millions of dollars for political candidates and charitable organizations throughout the nation. In 2000, Mrs. Goetz was recruited to serve as executive director for Bob Casey Jr.'s reelection campaign for Pennsylvania State Auditor General. In 2002, she served in the same capacity for the Bob Casey for Governor election. In 2003, Auditor General Casey turned to Mrs. Goetz to serve as campaign manager for his bid for state treasurer. Treasurer Casey was elected with more votes than any other candidate for any office in the history of the Commonwealth. As Bob Casey's Western Pennsylvania campaign manager, she led the effort resulting in his successful run for the United States Senate. Throughout her career, Mrs. Goetz has been instrumental in the advancement of the interests of numerous nonprofits and major corporations, such as Lloyd's of London, Verizon, and Oracle. In support of Oracle, she led the project to merge the financial management software systems of the City of Pittsburgh and Allegheny County, saving taxpayers millions of dollars. She also played a key role in the development of Heinz Field, home of the Pittsburgh Steelers, as well as projects for Hershey Entertainment and Resort Company and the City of Philadelphia. While representing Mine Safety Appliances, Mrs. Goetz secured funding for the critical research and development of advanced tactical hearing protection for the fighting men and women of our nation's armed forces. Mrs. Goetz is recognized across the Commonwealth by political organizations, nonprofits, and public leaders as an accomplished political professional with the compassion and drive to make a difference in Pennsylvania. Her accomplishments earned her a selection to the list of Pennsylvania's top 24 most politically powerful women. In 2006, Mrs. Goetz was honored with the Distinguished Alumni Award from the Brownsville Area Schools Alumni Association, and in 2014, she was the recipient of California University of Pennsylvania's Wilbur Samuel Jackman Alumni Award of Distinction. Mrs. Goetz is also a member of the Waynesburg University Board of Trustees and Gateway Health Plan Board of Directors as an independent director. Politics was a family value instilled in Mrs. Goetz by her late father, Ron DeSalvo, who was a pillar in Fayette County and regional politics. Ron served 18 years as a Luzerne Township supervisor and roadmaster. He played a vital role in transportation and infrastructure projects in the region. Numerous family members have had the privilege of holding elected office and proudly serve in various public safety positions throughout southwestern Pennsylvania since the early 1950s. Mrs. Goetz was born and raised in Fayette County. She earned her Bachelor of Science degree in Business and Marketing from California University of Pennsylvania. Mrs. Goetz resides in Rosslyn Farms, Allegheny County, with her husband Blake and their two sons, Chase and Max. Please join me now in giving a warm welcome to Mrs. Vanessa DeSalvo Goetz.
Thank you, Chairman, excuse me, thank you, Provost Barnhart, for that warm welcome. Graduates, this is your day. Madam President Jones, trustees, administrators, faculty, staff, family, and friends, it's an honor to be back at California University. I can't begin to articulate the level of excitement I felt when I was asked to deliver this address. It is a privilege to join the ranks of corporate CEOs and military generals before me. So after I agreed to give this speech, I excitedly made my way home for the evening to share this news with my family. While everyone was proud of me, my son's main concerns had to do with logistics. Chase, my six-year-old, wanted to know if there'd be any toys here. And Max, my four-year-old, had only one question. Mommy, are they going to have any chicken fingers there? I responded, of course there will be toys and chicken fingers. It's a standard at all college graduations. Right, Madam President? I grew up 5 miles away from here. College was an extension of our community. It was a place we all wanted to be after we graduated. In fact, some of my childhood friends are here this evening. So many people who are still a huge part of my life graduated from this great university. My husband, my sister, my cousins, the list goes on and on. Our parents had such an immense level of pride that we were all getting a college education. College was something neither of my parents got to experience. It was not an option for them. My mother was the youngest of 9 brothers and sisters. My father worked a blue-collar job his whole life. So it was a big deal to them. So this day is never yours to cherish. It's a vastly important day for everyone in your life who helped you get to this moment. As a mother of 2 young boys, I can hardly imagine the pride I would feel to be here on this Mother's Day weekend. In fact, if you are a mother, please stand. Let's give our mothers a round of applause they so greatly deserve. Thank you for everything you've done along the way. This campus is beautiful and has changed a lot since I studied here. The character and values this school imparts on its alumni, however, remain the same. When I'm back on campus, I'm always drawn to my memories of my classes with Dr. Mike Rich, who was Professor Rich at the time, who was the marketing professor to have back in my day. Dr. Rich made me feel like I could package and sell anything. And with that confidence and poise, and with the help of my support system, I got an internship. And this CalU grad from Fayette County found herself immersed in the world of politics, running statewide political campaigns. The track I was on put me into rooms I never thought I'd enter and introduced me to people I never thought I'd meet. Years later, it empowered me to do the unthinkable, start my own business. My philosophy is that no job is too big or too small. I answered phones, I did data entry, I stuffed envelopes late at night. I met everybody I could possibly meet, from the blue-collar workers in the state capitol building, to the legislators' staffers, to the lawmakers themselves. If there was a deadline, I met it. If there was a rule, I didn't break it. No job was beneath me, and after a long time, I achieved success. It didn't happen overnight, and it won't happen overnight for you. Success is long-term, and if you're focused and work hard, you will be successful in any area of work you choose. I chose politics, and politics is everywhere. It's not just reserved for the campaign trail. Much of life is political, from corporate boardrooms to small startups. And everybody at some point lobbies. You hear a lot of negative talk about special interest, but every interest is special to somebody. We all advocate on behalf of something or someone at some point, whether it's during a Little League game or in the United States Capitol. There really isn't a degree for what I do, but there's an industry for which I belong. I help companies, nonprofits, and organizations educate and inform their government. And I get those groups to work together to shape public policy and bring about positive change. I studied marketing. That's not to say I don't use my degree. In a way, I market ideas to stakeholders every day. I didn't graduate with this skill set. I worked for it. My degree provided an excellent foundation. If anyone's interested in following a career path similar to mine, the timing is perfect. Jump on a campaign. State representative, state senator, U.S. Congress, presidential, city council, the list goes on and on. There are a million campaigns going on right now, and there's no better introduction to my world than in the ground level of politics. Knock on doors, make phone calls, brew coffee, pick up dry cleaning, do whatever you have to do to get on a campaign. And then be a sponge. Listen and learn. You'll learn how to do research. You'll learn how to balance a budget. It's a great lesson in being a part of something bigger. I started at the same level of you when I graduated. By the time I was 29, I was running the floor for the Pennsylvania delegation at the 2000 Democratic National Convention in Los Angeles. Politics can be a very exciting field. And since I'm giving out advice now, here's a bit more. Be absolutely fearless. Have courage. Embrace the danger of failure. Thrive in it. I never learned more than I did after a defeat. Find the small achievements in even your fruitless endeavors, and you will walk away stronger and wiser. Along the way, there may be people who want you to fail, who may be working against you. And the higher up the mountain you get, the more people may try to drag you down. Ignore them. Your work and your dedication will always speak for themselves. You'll taste victory and defeat. One moment you will bask in the sunlight, the next you'll be the center of the storm. You'll land your dream job, get a raise, get a promotion, start your own business. And you might get fired, laid off, or demoted. You might get married, and you might get divorced. You're going to be healthy, but you might get sick. You're going to be very, very happy, and you're going to be very, very frustrated. Remember, every success, failure, joy, and sorrow will only make you stronger. Your education does not end this day. This is only the beginning. I learn something new every day on the job and in life, and so will you. Life does not progress in a straight line. Be prepared and understand that. Careers evolve. Priorities shift. You'll start somewhere and end up someplace else. And you know what? That's okay. That's a beautiful thing. Embrace change. Nobody works for the same company 9 to 5 for 30 years and retires anymore. Your first job won't be your last stop. For that matter, your first job may not even be in your field of study. And that's okay too. Ask for help. Lean on your support system. Along the way, people will help you get to where you need to be. Never forget them, honor them, and always remember to be that person for others. What a time to go out into this world to see what you're made of. You are part of the most educated generation to ever walk this planet. We landed on the moon with less technology than you carry in your pockets right now. You hold almost all of the world's knowledge in the palm of your hand. But here's the catch. Now, anything you write, say, or post ends up anywhere at any time. It defines you as a person and as a professional. And the consequences of your actions are more immediate than ever. Remember that history has its eye on you. Live your life like your biography is being written by the choices you make. Perception is reality. Hard work is the common denominator in every single achievement out there. Make hard work a habit. Let quality distinguish you from the pack. Make it your brand, your MO. Make excellence what people remember you by. Oftentimes, the choice is between doing something right and doing something the easy way. Do the right thing. Some are born with God-given talents and life situations that create an immediate platform for achievement. Those are variables. Strive to do the right thing, play by the rules, be kind to others, and choose to be fearless. There are two key factors to your success that are totally in your control: your work ethic and the choices you make. A woman leads this great institution. Women make up 58% of this graduating class. I charge you all to be the generation that finally pays women more than men for the same work. The gap is closing, but I challenge you, women, and especially men, to continue to be stewards of this progress and make history. Be sensitive to the fact that we are all trying to strike the balance between work and home life. We are all in this together. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life. I charge you to fight for equality for all, to not just think outside the box, demolish the box, and build something better, to find people who inspire you and stick with them, to seek out perspectives that drastically differ from yours, to keep in touch with your friends. Your friends from college will be your friends forever. And to never, as Prince would say, let the de-elevator bring you down. And remained anchored in the principles you established here at California University of Pennsylvania. I wish you all joy, health, and friendship. I wish you success in a place you call home. I wish you the wisdom to enjoy the good times in life and the patience and the will to get through the bad. I wish you the energy and the faith to make a difference in this world, to move mountains, to heal the sick, to help the needy, and to never, ever forget where you came from. Thank you and congratulations.
The University Choir will now present another selection for your listening enjoyment, A Scottish Blessing by David Blackwell.
Thank you.
With an introduction of the academic hood and presenting the candidates for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Arts Teaching, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, Master of Science, and Master of Social Work is Dr. Stanley Kamasik, Dean of the School of Graduate Studies and Research.
President Jones, members of the Council of Trustees, Mrs. Goetz, members of our stage party, faculty, families, guests, and most importantly, graduate candidates. On behalf of the graduate faculty, I wish to thank all of our graduate candidates for pursuing their academic endeavors at California University of Pennsylvania. At its core, a university is about teaching and learning, and the lives of both students and faculty are certainly enriched in the process. We thank you and congratulate you on your achievement. Special congratulations to the candidates wearing honors, cords, and pins, which signify completion of graduate work at California University of Pennsylvania with a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.75. Let's congratulate those candidates. In a few moments, we will begin the centuries-old academic tradition of hooding each graduate candidate to symbolically recognize their scholarly achievements and passage from student to master. A detailed description of the significance and distinction of our academic regalia can be found within our commencement program. Candidates, our herald, Dr. Christina Torres, will announce your names, and I will have the privilege of vesting each candidate with an academic hood. Once vested, you will present yourself in full academic regalia to the president of the university to receive your diploma and to be congratulated for this significant accomplishment. Candidates, as you go forward into the future, I hope you will recall fondly this important day when we honored your achievements by honoring long-standing academic traditions. The degree candidates from the School of Graduate Studies and Research will rise, please. President Jones, the following persons have completed all the requirements for the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Arts Teaching, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, Master of Science, Master of Science in Nursing, and Master of Social Work. They have been approved by the faculty and are presented for the degrees. Dr. Torres, will you please announce the specific curriculum and the candidates?
Master of Arts, Social Science Curriculum, Matthew Ryan Starkey. Social Science, Applied Criminology Curriculum, Christina J. Causer. Kelsey Lee Edstrom. Alexis Nicole Eichelsbacher. Amber Marie Griffin. Bria D. J. Crystal Renee Johnson. Melissa Renee Linsenbigler. Wendy L. Pennington. Melissa J. Roddenberry. Master of Arts Teaching, Chemistry Certification Curriculum, Chelsea M. Saylor. Communications Certification Curriculum, John Corby DeFlippo. Jonathan Edward Rolfe. The English Certification Curriculum, Maria Ann Tiger. The Social Studies Certification Curriculum, Michelle April Daly. Tabitha Lynn Fowler. Patrick L. Goebel. Lauren A. Kasula. Daniel Joseph Scarmese. Spanish Certification Curriculum. Stephanie Joyce Byers. Master of Business Administration Curriculum, Caitlin Marie Anderson. Maxwell Anthony Beaudry. Corey R. Bowersox. Anthony Alex Irungu. Shannon Elizabeth Johnson. Sean O'Neill Kahn. Joshua I. Lee. Patrick Travis Mitro. Gregory Michael Moore. Sihat Morgul. Sherry A. Moss. Shaquana Joshe Player. Shannon Marjorie Ray. Shehu Kamal Sule. Ian L. Wood. Esma Essin Yildirim. Ezgi Yildirim. Master of Education, Advanced Studies in Secondary Education Curriculum, Laura R. Johnson. Melissa R. Lupinacci. Scott Alexander Majeski. Ashley Marie Malik. Brian Michael Sherman. Ronald Edward Seiler. Reading Specialist Curriculum, Amy J. Guzik. School Counseling Curriculum, Kavon Kareem Bruce. Brooke Catlin Burnett. Yes, Caitlin Rose Hill. Jill Pizeski. David Allen Snell. Elizabeth C. Troth. Demi L. Williams. Special Education, 7 to 12 Curriculum, Michael James Seelhorst. Special Education, Dual Pre-K through 4, K through 8 Curriculum, Katie D. Hamilton. Brian Edward Weigel. Teacher Education, Early Childhood Education Curriculum, Melody Elizabeth McConnell. Teacher Education, English as a Second Language Without Certification Curriculum, Ashley N. Robotin. Teacher Education, Pre-K through 4 with Certification Curriculum, Courtney E. Kutzik. Rachel Maylee Lewis. Teacher Education, Science, Technology, and Math Education Curriculum, Sarah L.G. Ruffini. Technology Education Curriculum, Lori Ann Colangelo. Ashley Nicole McCreary. Master of Science, Athletic Training Curriculum, Dylan John Baxendale. Jessica Nicole Brogan. Heather Nicole Burris. Krista Lynn Capelli. Thomas James DeSimone. Michael Stephen Dion. Ona Maria Elo. Jared Thomas Estridge. Tyler Martin Falcao. Victoria Ann Fluharty. Corey Gentile. Michael Patrick Claver. Elizabeth Marie Kohling. Kevin Edward Koshorik. Alex Robert Leonardi. Meredith Jane Moore. Lionel Wayne Rice Jr. Cassidy Shearer. Jacob Eugene Schultz. Erica Vanessa Soto. Caitlin Joanne Waltz. Clinical Mental Health Counseling Curriculum, Mallory Rebecca Coder. Matthew G. Dipiatic. Stacy Renee Dabina. Carissa J. Goins. Kimberly N. Groover. Amanda Clersey. Zachary Edward O'Connor. Jasmine Monique Owens. Mariah Cheyenne Provins. Haley Irene Roycroft. Aaron K. Ryan. Shannon C. Scott. Kelsey Beth Smith. Communication Disorders Curriculum. Joseph Frank Arafa. Audrey L. Berg. Jill P. Borland. Melissa Catherine Braun. Alexandra Eve Cellurel. Angela N. Crump. Heather M. Domian. Maggie Eileen Drew. Rio Eshelman. Sarah Christine Forbes. Sarah Deborah Franzik. Caitlin Marie Green. Emily Catherine Hubbard. Kayla Marie Hudak. Kelsey Nicole Humlin. Emily Teresa Laver. Abigail Marie Mildner. Sydney Paige Mosley. Bethany D. Pyatt. Samantha L. Ray. Sabrina Maria Theobald. Amanda Michelle Wingrove. Brittany P. Woodrow. Exercise Science and Health Promotion, Performance Enhancement and Injury Prevention Curriculum, Talia Larice Lynn Allen. Natalie Elizabeth Buffalini. Angelia Renee Hill. Adam Jacob Horner. Mark Wallace Shepherd. Collis Ospitia Span. Chelsea Thompson. Exercise Science and Health Promotion Rehabilitation Sciences Curriculum, Ayana Rinell Baylor. Kimberly K. Fernandez. Kenja R. Hannaford. Exercise Science and Health Promotion, Sports Psychology Curriculum. Megan Tasia Baptisteller. Madison Renee Rotto. Exercise Science and Health Promotion, Wellness and Fitness, Christy Lee. Kayana Tanika Washington. Michael Robert Williams. Exercise Science and Health Promotion, Wellness Coaching Curriculum, Charles Jacob Erickson. Legal Studies, Criminal Justice Curriculum, Ashley L. Lee. Barton Lemansky. Legal Studies, Homeland Security Curriculum, Nathan Ray Amy. Sarah Christina McCowan. Legal Studies, Law and Public Policy Curriculum, Brandon C. Reese. Sport Management, Intercollegiate Athletic Administration Curriculum, Mark Walter Gordon. Sport Management, Generalist Curriculum, Drew Tyler Carpen. Ashley Simone Petway. Master of Science in Nursing, Abigail D. Averett. Patricia A. Dragone. Andrew John Eckel. Aggie Greer. Diane Lynn Hughes. Mary Jo Carnash. Tracy Kunsa. Christy Ann Moriarty. Master of Social Work, Scott Vincent Dioulas. Rachel L. Franks. Glenda Michelle Fulmer. Erica Lynn Grimm. Kelly Jean Halinka. Allison Louise Lainaala Hellman. Tammy Ray Henry. Melissa J. Klein. Caitlin May Massey. April Marie McCrum. Tawanda Lynn McGee. Lindsay Rose Nelson. Kim Ann Schusler. Rachel D. Sapizi. Rochelle L. Spielman. Maria Lee Tilka. Kathleen Casey Van Divner.
President Jones, several candidates have requested to graduate in absentia. Their names are listed in the program.
Madam President, the candidates who have been presented to you have been certified by the faculty and the dean as having fulfilled all the requirements for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Arts Teaching, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, Master of Science in Nursing, and Master of Social Work. I recommend that the degrees be conferred.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Governors of the Pennsylvania State System of Higher Education, I hereby confer the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Arts Teaching, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, Master of Science in Nursing, and Master of Social Work, with all the rights, honors, and privileges which throughout the world pertain to that degree. Master's graduates, be seated, please. It is my understanding that we have members of the graduating class as well as members of our audience who are active military or veterans. Please stand so that we may recognize your selfless service to our country. Thank you. We have another special group of individuals with us today, our alumni. Please know that you are important to us, and we truly appreciate all the support we receive from you. At this time, all of California University of Pennsylvania alumni in the audience, please stand so that we may recognize you for your dedication to your alma mater and to our students. Thank you. And finally, one last recognition, perhaps the most important recognition of all. To all the mothers in our graduating class and in our audience, please stand again. Happy Mother's Day to each of you. All of our master's graduates, congratulations. You have our very best wishes for a wonderful future. Be safe and take care and visit us often. In conclusion, we will now sing the first verse of our alma mater, after which Reverend Quisenberry will present the benediction, and I ask that the audience remain in their seats following the benediction and until the end of the recessional. Thank you. Have a safe evening.
Dear woman.
May God bless you and keep you, and in grateful response, may you love with passionate action, continue to pursue both knowledge and wisdom, and live lives of excellence and service, so that peace may be your constant companion and joy your life's song. Amen.